Hello everyone, Trigan here, and we are back in ARK Survival Evolved. Hey, we're running a little backwards and behind today, aren't we? Got our Dragon Age and our Subnautica videos done first this time. My schedule going backwards. You know, I logged in here and I'm a little confused. I don't know how this stuff got damaged. It's just this door frame and this wall. But what damage that? Oh, and this wall here too. But I have no idea what would have damaged them. What came up here and damaged these walls? Well, I'm not going to worry about it at the moment. I just stepped in here to check out our plants and see how they're doing. I think they're doing okay. Yep. We're going to need to put some more fertilizer in them soon, but we seem to have a fair amount of that. Well, our doors are fixed. It's so wonderful. Thank you, mod author. Okay, so I've done some work on the stuff we were working on before. I'm not sure how far we were on the tower and everything, but here's the tower. Yeah, we did go over this before. I got the battlements up on here. I'm strongly leaning towards putting railings on the side with occasional gaps for us to jump down through. But the big thing over here is I got rid of that ugly behemoth wall we had over here. Which it turns out, for some bizarre reason, those behemoth walls appear to be damaged as if they were wood structures, even though they're stone ones. So some sort of error in the mod there. But I got a regular wall put in over here, and we can actually even climb up onto these battlements here if we want to. But it's tall enough that it will keep things out, so we're in good shape there. The worst thing is that we keep opening this door when we get close to it. I also got started on the north side. I got just the basics for the wall down here. It really was a lot of fiddly work, which is why I didn't want to record it. Because I had to keep it so that we weren't so deep in the water that we couldn't... See, I got a door in here too. Moved our forges over so we can have that. I had to be careful that it wasn't so deep in the water that it, you know, we couldn't place foundations. I guess the triangle foundations have not been updated yet. Oh well, that's fine. Modder's busy. But obviously I didn't want it so far in that it blocked all passage through that way. So this is what I came up with. See, it works pretty well. We don't have any weird gaps at the bottom. A little bit there, but not bad. I think I need to put some ramps out here. Oops. And these doors don't want to let me through. The doors really don't like me on foot. And I need to extend the foundations in here. That'll help a little bit. But you see, I've got the setup, so we're going to be doing it. Come on, close. Close. There we go. So we're going to be doing it the same way with these gaps for parking dinos in, though I don't know what on earth we'll be able to park down in that gap there. But the gap will be there, or, you know, the area will be there if we need it. Might also become a forge area or something like that. I'd like to put a tower out here too, probably somewhere around where this bend is. I'm just not sure exactly where yet, so that is to be determined. But yeah, I've actually been out collecting stone this morning. Well, actually it's afternoon now. Out collecting stone on Joan so that we can close those doors. So that we can continue building that stuff, but we do need more wood too. So let's go ahead and do a little montage action to get our day going right on Lady Sybil here. Wait a minute. Let's give Lady Sybil, I guess, some more damage. All right, off we go. Oh, and now this door is sitting. we are back under cover of darkness here. Oh, I think I got enough wood, because we can just barely move Lady Sybil here. Oh, can I get around behind the building here? Get her into her parking spot. There we go. Beautiful. Now, I saw in the mod author's notes for the auto torches that he has increased the range of light. I can't really tell in here because we've got the electric light, but yeah, it does seem to be giving a nice wider area of light. The amount of light we were getting was so bad, I don't know what changed. I don't think it was the mod author. I think it was something that changed in ARK, because it just seemed like everything was darker. All right, let's get our wood. Wood. Lady Sybil. Joan's got a little bit on her. That looks good. And let's see about... She probably has thatch on her, too. Lady Sybil and Joan both. Okay, cool. So we've got that taken care of. Let's go out and have a look-see at what we're going to need here. We're going to need lots of walls. And I'm not sure how many. Oh, we need these door frames, too. Let's see how many we're going to need. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Looks like we need 7 of them. So let's go ahead and take care of that first. And then we'll figure out how many walls we're going to need. So you've seen what I'm doing with it. You know where I'm going with it. We just want it to, you know, look nice. Oh, I forgot I had some meat on me. While I was out on Joan, we got attacked by... We got attacked by some compies and by a couple of spitters, and well, I figured they were just trying to aid in our narcotics making ventures. Maybe they saw too much Breaking Bad, I don't know. And we'll put their hides in here. It looks like the sun's coming up, so we can go ahead and put that away. And let's just go ahead and get a few walls going. We know we're going to need some. 36. That looks good. And we got these ready. Let's go ahead and put them out. So these are, again, that's the workstation for the Extra ARK 2.0. And these are nice because they're like dino-sized door frames, but they're only 2 walls high. And 2 wide, just like the dino gates. But they're great for something like this where you want a large opening, but don't want to just leave it open. You want some sort of, you know, structure support. You know, in this case, we need, you know, 1 more row of walls on top of it. So we use them to support the walls on the layer above. So, oh, we still need to work on the outside wall here. So, see... 1, 2. Ugh, this is gonna be hard to count now. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So we need 42 walls altogether. So yeah, we were definitely right then that we would be fine making those 36 walls. Let's take this stuff out of here and put it back in here. Because we're going to need walls on the other side, too. Take our 36 walls. And let's go ahead. I don't know if I want to make... Yeah, I guess we'll go ahead and tell them to go ahead and make 30, because we'll probably need all of them. And then we're going to be out of stone and stuff. Isn't that great? So, I think I will either edit this part out and we'll do our BRBs, or I will montage it for you. There's no sense in making you sit and watch me place walls. If you saw it or not, but we have really done some damage to the stone resources in this area. You know, and I think that Lady Bronto out here is looking for Droopy. She's just been, you know, making her way slowly closer and closer to the house. So let's go ahead and finish up this last bit of wall here. Come on, get in there. Oh. No wonder that didn't fit. Okay, I actually made more walls than I needed to. Now, somewhere along here, I want to do a staircase, and I'm not sure how I'm going to go about doing that. So it's got to be 3 high. I don't really want it to be 1, 2, 3... Let's try this. Now I have, the ARK Extras has a wooden, I wish I had a stone version, but they don't. They have a wooden corner ceiling, or corner, yeah, corner ceiling, quarter ceiling, not corner ceiling. Hello? Can I, oh, edit for just a second. There we go. A wooden quarter ceiling, which, would allow us to have sort of a walkway past. Come on. It is not going to let us here. Let's do this old trick here. Go up. Yeah. Oh, we can't get up there. Okay, well, that trick isn't going to work then, is it? That would allow us to have a walkway around the half stairs here. Oh, there we go. Got it. Oh, we had it there for a second. Boy, I tell you, why is this stuff so hard to place? Oh, goodness sakes. Alright. Now we can do this trick. That's that I'm sure of. Alright, so now we'll come back and we will pick it up, and now we can put it down and have it face the wrong way again. There we go. Oh, there we go. Much better. Close. Don't want you open. Okay, cool. So, we've got this up to here. Yeah, I think I'll make some of those quarter ceilings go around this and some railings. And that way we'll be able to stand down here on this part of the wall if we want to. But we do have some stairs up there. And we'll, like I said, I'll put in a tower, I think, at some point. Probably right around here somewhere. I'm not sure exactly where or how, but something like that. And that will let us... that'll let us access the wall from this area here, as well as giving us a small structure to do things from. And the next bit here, let's see. I don't know how many ceilings we're going to need. Let's see. I don't need another one of these right now, but I do want one of those. Okay. And we'll come back out here. And this, I think, is a cool bit. Just wait till you see this. There we go. I'm sort of wondering if that snapped to the right thing. Well, it sure does rain a lot on this map. I guess it rains like this in the center, too, but... Man, that's a lot of rain. Right here. Take out this stone battlement, and then we will take these stairs, place them right here, and they will go the wrong direction and really annoy me. Pick up the stairs. Maybe if we do this. And then try doing it from this direction, which hasn't worked previously, but why does they want a place facing the opposite direction? There we go. Okay, see? Now we'll be able to go from the roof of our house onto the wall here, sort of the same way we do the over here, but over there we've got that stairwell, and here we don't have the stairwell. So in this, I think, we will use some regular walls here. You know, that's not even close to where you were placed on my screen. There we go. We'll do the same thing on the other side. There we go. And probably put battlements on the tops of these here. Oh, we're going to need some triangle ceilings, I forgot. Looks like we'll need two of them. And the nice thing about the Structures Plus stuff is that even though I'm gonna, you know, come back later and build the tower, I won't lose these materials. I'll be able to just pick them up and then place them back down again. And that leaves us some for over there after I get the quarter ceilings in. There we go. So how about that? It's looking pretty good. Looking pretty good indeed. And I'm wondering if I can do a tower right here in this spot. That would be sort of cool to have a tower on this corner here. And you see we got some dry ground there, so it should be easy enough to place foundations. One of the things the modder added is, now I don't know if I showed you this before, I think I had, the foundations now match the walls. And also the modder's going to change the triangle foundations the same way. But also, these things will now, they will sort of stack and clip, clip to each other. So, you know, like if the ground is a little too high, you can place it up a little, place the next foundation up a little higher and it'll snap. And he's made the foundations the same height as walls, so it works out perfectly. So you can actually see it here, I think. Oh, no, I guess not. Oops. Might be able to. Yeah, and I hit tab because I was playing Subnautica earlier. But yeah, that's actually how I got these. These are foundations right here, and we're stuck in here. Come on, let me out. There we go. And you see, they actually snapped. You see, these are actually stacked. There's foundation and a foundation. They did actually stack. The mod says they won't stack, but they actually will. But it works out really nicely because I'm able to get around the funky heights. Now, obviously, we still had the problem of the earth and the wall here. Oh, you can see it stacked a little bit here. But it still allows us to keep this all even and have a nice, neat, even wall, despite the fact that the ground is very uneven there. Are you going to close? No, you're going to sit open. Close. Stupid wall. Stupid doors. Those doors are so handy, but when they do that, it's such a nuisance. Did I just hear them open again? No, I'm just hearing things. Probably paranoia. So let's see now. So getting this upgraded was a big part of what I wanted. It just, it looks so much nicer in here now. I can't believe it. I didn't expect it to look so much nicer. I mean, I was unhappy about losing our view, but now this really does. When we get the crenellations on over there, or the battlements, this really will be looking a lot like a, you know, some sort of a medieval fort. And I like it. I like it a lot. I think this has just come out so very well. I'm just really pleased with the way it all looks. Okay, enough. I'm not trying to toot my own horn there. I mean, I'm just putting stuff together where it goes. It's really the people responsible for it are the modder, the Structures Plus mod, just the terrain itself. The way the terrain laid out, it made it interesting to build here. A lot more so than I ever expected. You remember this little blank spit of land that was here when we got here? You know, this little bare sort of ugly piece of beach that we were going to build on? You know, it's like, oh, well, we got a nice view, but, you know, an ugly little piece of beach, it'll work. But, and now we've got this beautiful place, a big house, and a dock, and castle walls and our skylight and green. I'm just really, really tickled with how this all looks right now. Okay, let's give ourselves two ceilings here. Let's take some wood. Let's take this thatch and all of this fiber. And let's see. I think we're going to need six. Of those quarter ceilings. I don't know if we can make that many. I don't know if we even have the ingroom. We do now. Okay. Can we do six? Oh yeah, we can do six. So that'll let us walk around the staircase there. Put this here, stone. I want three of those, and then I want. We need a half. We need a half one here. I thought we had more ceilings. What happened to our ceilings? Didn't we have? Oh, that was the walls I was looking at. We had four left. We are going to need more ceilings. Let's see, and I want this right here. Take all from inventory. None. Whoa, can I get it back in there? Just a little overweight, just a little. We'll take these. And let's go have a look-see over here. I'm not sure how many ceilings we're going to need on the other side of this. Looks like just two. Maybe three? Yeah, three. We want a third one there. Here, now we can do this. These are a little touchy to place, but see, because they'll fit sort of halfway. Seems like they've got a few different snap points. But they are so handy. I used to use them on the front of my boats, my boat designs, because they made for a nice little forecastle. And I think that's it. Now we need our three stone ceilings. And we can put our triangle ceilings in while we're doing this. And I guess so these triangle things are going to get remodeled so that they fit better. Remember how we had the trouble with the gaps? And I'm not seeing any here, thankfully. But you remember we had the trouble with the gaps. I guess that's going to get fixed when the modder rebuilds all of the triangle stuff, redesigns it or whatever. And let's see, I'm going to take all these resources here. Oh, what did I do that for? I don't want to do that yet. We need three more ceilings. Go all the way to the bottom here. I'm going to build a fourth just for safety's sake. And we don't need any more walls. We are going to need battlements. Actually, before we do that, we're going to need these. Take these for now. So like that. And I want to take all of this here. And let's start building some of these. I don't know how many we're going to need. Let's try 22. Okay. I probably won't have you guys in for building the tower when I build a tower out here, but I will show it to you when. Excuse me, her and her tail, I tell you. Yeah, you know what? I could have done that. I might do that a little different. I don't need to have it open that whole way, come to think of it, because of need to have it open for a certain distance so that our head doesn't get stuck trying to come up the stairs. But I don't think that's a worry here, and since we have an extra ceiling, we'll go ahead and do that. And then we'll put this one right here. And then this one here, this one, come on. We want to get some stair railings too. So that's a problem I've had with these quarter ceilings, is the railings don't seem to want to fit quite right. There we go. Now let's put on a couple of our battlements here. There. So that'll be pretty nice. That'll be pretty nice. That's gonna look really nice when we're done. Ah, flying through the air. Take these. Then we can stick this extra stuff in there for later use. And let's start from the far end again. And I'll stick the ramps on here too, when off camera. I'm sure you guys know what a ramp looks like. You don't need to have to stand around and watch me put ramps in. Yeah, we'll put that like that. See how it looks from the outside. Actually, I think she's stuck on those rocks now. Yeah, that looks fine. I like that. Okay. Close. Okay. Yeah, maybe I should have put the stairs a little bit further away so we didn't have the stupid doors opening every time we went up them. But You know, we probably won't be using them unless we're coming into the stair or coming in through the gates or something. Oh, that's not where I wanted it, is it? Okay. There. Oh, come on. That's not where I was trying to place one, but okay, it worked. And yeah, I probably should have done these, you know, whoops. Once again, not where it was showing it was going to be built. I probably should have done these before putting the ceilings up so that they didn't end up at different heights because of the multiple snap point issue. But it's just so much easier to do it once the wall is up here. Looks like we are two battlements short. Or three, depending on how we want to do it. Man, that looks really good. That looks really good. How did we do it over here? Do I want battlements on the inside? I don't think I put... No, I didn't. I just put walls there. So yeah, we need two more battlements. And put some ramps on, and then we will be all set with that. So this was part of our big plan for upgrade, you know, for growing our place. No, I didn't want that. I didn't want that either. Man, I cannot hit the right thing to save my life, can I? I can make 11 ramps. This is all part of our plan for that. And now that we've got this done, our facility here is now secure. You know, beyond flyers coming in, and I just don't see Argies coming clear down here to mess with us. We're too far from either of the Argy lands around us. I mean, there's Argies over at Forest Peak over there, and Argies in the cold area over there, but this area in between, there's just no Argies. Something can come down off the... Ooh, level up. Something could come down off the cliff, and we will have to address that at some point, but I'm not really very worried about that right now. I was more concerned that we did have things like, mainly spitters, occasionally trikes and things like that. They were really just a nuisance, but they were coming around the gates, probably being chased or by something or chasing something, and then they ended up wandering around in here and just being a nuisance. So that's all taken care of. It looks nice. I'm really pleased with the way it came out, appearance-wise. Let's just leave that off. Give us a nice review. So now we've got these areas here. I need to get some feeding troughs out. I wish the electric had worked out the way the modder wanted it to, because it would have been real nice if we could have just, instead of having to set up electric everywhere, if we could have just had it all flow right through all these foundations. We've got the whole thing connected, so if the electric worked through it, it would just be fantastic. But I think what we're going to have to do is I'm going to get that tower built over there, however I end up building it, whatever location I end up building it. And we'll end up putting a solar cell on the roof of that tower and a solar cell on the roof of this tower. And then what I want to do is replace... Well, what I actually want to do first is replace our feeding trough with an electric feeding trough, a refrigerated one. That way we can keep meat in there for our meat eaters, which, come to think of, I haven't fed them today. That way we can keep meat in there for the meat eaters and not worry about them being hungry, and getting the feeding troughs out to the other areas will allow us to... That's going to go in crafting speed. Getting feeding trough up and out into those other areas will allow us to extend the area we can, you know, store our critters. Say I had food in there and it rotted. Or meat in there, I should say. So then we can start making use of those little nooks that we've just created in the outer walls to keep like the wolves and stuff like that. And when we get new dinos, keep them too. And I think most likely these guys, at least these two guys, are going to get moved out too. I'm not sure about the dillos because you can't ride them, so you can't place them in the nooks. Because you really have to sort of ride stuff in and place it in the nooks. I might be able to get them, if I put them on very low following distance, maybe I can, you know, walk up here and get them to stand on the ramp. But I do want to get some more female dillos and some more female scorpions so that we can get some eggs going for our kibbles. When we hit level 80, there is an automated egg collector that we can use to collect eggs for us. And then once we have the egg farm becomes a lot easier to deal with, because then the eggs will just be collected by that, and you know, we can also just leave the eggs in it as storage. But we can also get, like, you know, a few dodos for eggs, and start getting creatures lined up to produce eggs for getting kibbles for some of the bigger stuff we want, like a high level Rex. And things like that. So I think that's it for this episode. Wait, let me get a nice picture so we can see what we look like here with our wall in the background. Isn't that awesome? So thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please smash that thumbs up button. Really helps me out knowing that people are enjoying the videos. And of course, please subscribe if you haven't already. And most importantly, you have a great day.